The National Association of Realtors, or NAR, is projecting a slower growth in home prices in 2018 gawa ng bagong tax law called the Tax Cuts and Jobs Act. Now, yung tanong, how is the real estate market affected by this new tax law? Liwanagin natin with Rob and Ning here to share their expertise. Guys, kumusta? Hello.
Hi, JC.
Hi, JC.
Give us some highlights of this new tax law insofar as it relates to homeowners or real estate.
Okay, so first off, some things that are good, right? Tax rates came down for individuals as well as corporations, especially for corporations. Mm-hmm. They didn't change the exclusion on personal residence, meaning that if you have a gain of up to $500,000, if you're married, that's all tax-free, mm-hmm. $250,000 for single, right? And the exclusion rule didn't change the time frame. It's still 2 years out of the last five, and the proposal was 5 out of 8. So those things are very, very good for real estate.
Right.
Yeah.
Okay.
So what does that mean for me if I have I'm sitting on some equity? What should I know in terms of whether now is the right time to possibly sell?
Well, first off, there's some bad things in the tax.
Okay,
that affect real estate. Okay, those were good that I share, but there are some bad. And so, some of those things are that they have a new tax called SALT, mm-hmm. right, for state and local income tax. Mm-hmm. It's capped to
10,000.
Yeah.
Right. 10,000. And then the yung interest deduction natin, right? Dati na 1 million, ngayon naging 750 lang. Pero kung ang property mo, you bought it before before December 14, 2017, then grandfathered yon, na ibig sabihin, you can still, yung interest deduction mo, kahit 1 million will still be deductible. Yung equity line of credit, hindi na siya magiging tax deductible. Unless na yung pinaggamitan mo ng equity line of credit, maipapatunay mo na yun ay ginamit mo sa pagpapaayos ng bahay. Okay? So, yung sinasabi ni Rob na 10,000 capped, we have an example actually na let's say halimbawa ang bahay mo is 800,000. Ang property tax mo is $8,000. And then ang iyong state income tax, let's say you earn 60,000, right? Sa California is 7.5%. So, ang magiging, yun palang dalawa na yun, is 12,500. Eh, ang sabi ng bagong batas, it's up to 10,000 lang. Mm-hmm. So, that means na yun lang 10,000 ang iyong magiging tax deductible. We need to understand na ang property natin is the biggest tax write-off natin yun. That's why we want to own a property, right? But the good news is, yung standard deduction naman itinaas ng 24,000. So what that means is, kung dati the way we file taxes is may Schedule A tayo para we itemize everything, ngayon, instead na kagaya nitong example natin, siguro instead na mag-itemize deduction siya, mag-standard deduction na lang siya kasi 24,000 ang magiging standard deduction in 2018 for married and then pag single is 12,000.
So sa example na binigay mo dyan, Ning, it looks like some people will have to pay more taxes with this new law. Will it also mean that some people will want to downsize so that they don't have to pay those taxes?
Mm-hmm. That's right. Yeah.
Absolutely.
Possible.
I mean, so many people, if they're downsizing or thinking about it in the next, say, 5 years, now's a good time to do it because the people are thinking that this new tax might have a dampening effect on higher end properties because of the taxes. So if you want to salvage your equity because you're downsizing in the next five, now's not a bad time to do it, right?
Yeah.
Inventories are tight and so.
Now's not a bad time to do it or now is a good time to do it?
There's well, yeah. Right. I should rephrase that.
Okay.
Now is a good time okay. to do that, yeah.
But if there's one takeaway that you would give in terms of a strategy to make the new tax law work for us, mm-hmm. the homeowner, what would it be as a parting shot?
Well, the first thing I would look at is your time horizon. If your taxes are above the 10,000 cap, look at your time horizon. If you're working, your kids are in school, don't worry about mm-hmm. it. But if your time horizon is less than 5 years of selling, now's not a bad time to mm-hmm. do it and capture that equity.
Mm-hmm. And also, if we can avoid to get second loan, HELOC, and just keep our loan one, mm-hmm. you can cash out, but mm-hmm. keep your loan one, yeah. that will help. Because next year, it's not tax deductible yeah. anymore unless you use it for property, right? Mm-hmm. And then if you also have multiple properties, maybe it, this is the time then, instead of you claim it as personal, sa personal taxes mo, you form an LLC, a company, na magte-taker nung iyong multiple properties kasi right. there's an advantage that on the new tax law.
Mga Kanation, that's why we talked to Robin Ng because they can help advise with things like this to maximize your money, especially when it comes to real estate. If we need to reach you, where can our Kanation
sure, go? Sure, JC, thank you. Kanation, you can call us at 888-860-9530 or you can visit us online.
Or you can go to our website po and schedule yourself for a free consultation with either Robin or Janine.
Okay, thanks guys. We'll see you again next week.
Thanks.